Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Charlotte. If you're not new here, thanks for coming back. And today I'm going to be filming one of my favorite videos. I filmed this last year and it was so much fun. This is my Kylie Cosmetics Holiday Christmas Collection, which is so cute this year. I'm really excited. Just a quick note, thank you guys for bearing with me. I was absent for a few weeks. I had a bunch of stuff going on with school, and I just took a wonderful, amazing vacation. So I hope everyone had an amazing Thanksgiving. You are happy and healthy, and everything is going great. So let's get into this collection. I got the goods. Normally, I get the, like, Kylie's Favorites collection, but there were a few things in there that I just wasn't interested in. I did not want the brush set. I have a lot of brushes. I do not need any more brushes, and hers are pretty expensive, less expensive than her like brush kit, but they were still expensive. And then I didn't want the eyeliner, so I didn't get the eyeliner because I don't really have a use for red eyeliner. I also saw some negative reviews about the red eyeliner. What else did she have in that collection? Oh, she had those two lipsticks that were traditional bullet lipsticks, and I just didn't think I was going to get any use out of those because I already have Mary Jo in a Kylie Cosmetics single. So, oh, and the eye glazes, which I thought were gorgeous, but I just couldn't justify them. Here they are. This is less than I got last year, but it's still significant, and my wallet is crying. Yes. This is so, the packaging this year is like my favorite packaging she's ever done because it's so festive and it's so on point. The glitter is everywhere. It's not like a really, sometimes like Marc Jacobs just did a collection with glitter where it was like encased. It's not that kind of glitter that doesn't come off. It is the, you know, it's glitter. It's gonna come off. There's red glitter all over me. But it's fine. I like it. So this is Naughty List, which is gorgeous. I'll just go over an overview of what I got. This is the miniature set. Last year, I do have the last year's collection to compare, but this was 8 last year, and now this is 6. The palette, which is so cute. We'll go deeper into the packaging when I focus on this product, but it's so adorable. And then the high glosses, because the high glosses are some of my favorite products Kylie does. They're so good. I love them. The first thing I want to concentrate on is the palette. This is the Dear Santa palette, the holiday palette. This is the outer packaging, which is different than the inside packaging. Last year, she did the Chill Baby palette, which looked like this in the inside. This was $44, I think, and this one was $48, so it is a bit of an increase in the price, but I think you're getting more shadows. We'll check on that later. But this palette was okay. I didn't, like, love it. I didn't like how the shadows didn't really match the outer packaging, but these shadows in here, I honestly am drawn to a lot more, so I'm excited. So the Santa Claus or Dear Santa palette. Let's look at her. It says Christmas with a K. I'm sorry. Also, my nails. They're really gross right now. I have to paint them. But it says Christmas with a K. It is so cute. It has like the airmail, little stamp details. Santa Claus. Oh, it's so cute. And then in the back, the envelope is like sealed with a kiss, which is adorable. Her packaging is always to die for. It's probably what she spends like a lot of money on, but I love the holiday packaging. It just gets me in such a good mood. The eyeshadow palette itself is like covered in glitter all over it. If you can see, like, it has glitter all over the packaging, which I don't mind. Look how cute. Okay, the Dear Santa palette, look at how it has like the candy cane trimming. It's so cute. The back has the eyeshadow names, as always. That's pretty standard for Kylie's palettes. And then a little information at the bottom about the net weight, that kind of stuff. I believe this is a pressed pigment palette, so it's not all eyeshadows. It does have some pigments, I believe. Ooh, you got a nice mirror. And then look at how cute. I love the inside of this palette. There is a plastic sleeve. Ooh. I'm so excited. Who wants to swatch this? Oh my god, these look so beautiful. I just wanted to note you are getting 2 extra shadows in here than you were in this palette. So just a there's a $4 price difference, but you're getting two more shadows in here. This was $14, and this is $16. I do think her holiday palettes are usually a tad overpriced, but I can't resist them. I really can't. The first shade is KYLIE Christmas, which is not going to show up on me because it is a nude color, and I'm very, very pale. This is holiday season. That's so pretty. It's like very wet and metallic-y. Jolly AF. That is so gorgeous. Treat Your Elf. That one is a bit patchy, but still pretty strong for a red. This is Santa's Workshop. Oh my god, that one is so gorgeous. Santa's Workshop. And then Reindeer Dreams. That one's really pretty as well. Yeah, that's gorgeous. These are swatching a lot better than I remember the ones last year swatching. These feel a lot better quality, which is weird, but that's how I'm feeling. How Nice. And Santa's Helper. Kris Kringle. That one didn't really show up that well, but that was what the swatch was. And then Xmas Crush did not show up at all. That was some, let me just try to layer them a little bit. I was really excited for these shades. Xmas Crush. It's not really layering that much. And then what was this one? Oh no, that was Kris Kringle, and this was Xmas Crush, which is just kind of like a glittery purple topper. It's not really a true shadow, really. That one's, there was a similar shade in the other last year's Christmas palette that was kind of like that. They really just did not want to show up, which made me sad, but you know, oh well. This is Made You Cookies, which is honestly had so much pigment to begin with. Ooh, Made You Cookies. And then Hint of Naughty. I like that one. That one's really pretty. Yeah, most of the shimmers are really, really strong here, except for that weird purple shade. Peppermint Princess. That's a really pretty color. And then Secret Santa, which is a white. And again, whites don't really pick up on my skin tone like tans, but it's pretty. Mint to Be, which is like a traditional gold. I think I just swatched that over the white, so I'm sorry. But that is the traditional gold shade in Mint to Be. I feel like she's really worked on the formulation of her shimmers a lot. And then the last shade is Dearest, which is like a plummy color. I'm pretty impressed by these swatches. As far as KYLIE's eyeshadows go, her regular collections that stay in stock a long time usually are better than her limited edition collections, like her Christmas launches, which is unfortunate for sure. But this one I actually feel is way, way improved than her usual formula for holiday collections. Let me know how you feel if you are like me and you get it every year. Tell me what you think. But let's put this on the eyes because that's what really matters in the first place. Okay, welcome to my eyeballs. I'm going to go into Reindeer Dreams first, which is like a nudie transition-y color. This is really pigmented. Whoa! It's pigmented, but it's a bit patchy. Just gonna do the other side. I was doing looks when I did first impressions where I did one eye first, but I feel like I wasn't communicating my actual first impressions that way. So I'm going back to this format. If you have an opinion about which one, if you'd like to see just one eye, this is a boring but just like lovely shade. Reminds me of Tanacon from the Conspiracy palette. I did a whole video on the Conspiracy palette, but then didn't upload it because I didn't really like the palette. So let me know if you want to see that anyway. But I was kind of scared to upload it because I just did not have success with that palette. Now I'm going to go into, oh my goodness, I don't really want to do red because I know this has like some vibrant reds in there. But I'm just, that's not really my vibe. I'm going to go into Kris Kringle. I'm just going to go with the colors I like. They're boring, but that's basically my channel. So Kris Kringle, and Kris is spelled with a K, which is cute. I would believe someone if they told me Kris Jenner was Santa Claus. It makes a lot of sense, honestly. It's the only one I think could get that done. Okay, now I'm gonna go into Peppermint Princess, which is that shade. Struggles. And press that on the outer corner. The mattes have been working very flawlessly so far. I think I'm gonna go into Holiday Season, maybe, and take some of that and press it on the eye with my finger. It's almost like a pressed glitter, but they're very, very small pieces. Then I'm going to kind of try to blend that a bit to the rest of the eye with a bit of hint of Naughty. I'm going to go in with Secret Santa and just coat the inner corner. One of my favorite things to do with these kind of frosty colors. That's really pretty. It's a really pigmented shadow on the eyes. Then I'm going to press a little bit of Kris Kringle to kind of blend that look in. Now I'm going to take a little bit of Dearest, which is the darkest shade in the palette, and just add it to the very outer portion, just to spice it up a little bit. Okay, now finally I'm gonna take a little bit of Kris Kringle and Peppermint Princess and smudge out this lower lash line. Okay, I'm gonna go add mascara. I'll be right back. So those are the eyes finished, and I really, really like them. I had a bit of a mess with the kind of glittery shadow, but I really, really like this look. So I'm digging it. I think this is actually a bit higher quality than her palette last year. I don't have any really kickback in the pan, and there's very, very little fallout on my eyes. Normally when I'm working with Kylie's palettes, I like to do my eyes first and then add foundation later. But this one was not bad at all. I think it is so, 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 so cute. And what you're really buying here is like the Christmas aesthetic and the packaging. That's kind of the allure of the palette, really. So yeah, I actually really like the palette, which is, I expected to like it less, but I actually really, really liked it. So that is a bonus plus. Okay, so this is this year's packaging. This is last year's. This one was Baby It's Cold Outside, which was really cute. I just wanted to point out that last year there were 8 shades, and then this year there are 6 shades, but it looks like they may be the same size. Let me see. Yes, they're the exact same size, 0.03 ounces. She said this is her favorite lip collection she's done so far. Obviously, she says that kind of about every launch, but I actually really love the shades. Whenever she swatches them, though, they always look a lot lighter on her than they do on me. They always look darker on me, I guess because of my skin tone. But this is what the inside looks like. It's just, there's so much detail in her Christmas packaging, always. It has the names on the back. Let's try it on my mouth. Okay, snowman season. These are rough swatches, obviously, because I don't want to go digging to see matching lip liners for all of these, but this is snowman season, which I thought might be too weird on me, but it's actually really, really pretty. This is kind of a very stunning nude, which it's really, really pretty. I like it a lot. Just get a little closer. Snowman season. Okay, time for Team Santa. This is the roughest swatch I've done in a long time, but this is Team Santa. It's really, really pretty. It's kind of just like an every kind of girl color. Yeah, I did a really, really bad swatch with this. I'm very sorry. Rosy Cheeks, which is such a cute color. This one's got kind of a purpley hue. But it really does kind of give you the vibe, like, oh, I just came out of the snow. I'm so cute. Okay, this one is Santa's Real. This is really very pretty. It's kind of like a beginner red because it's not quite red. But it's very, very pretty. It's like a rosy red. Again, rough, rough, rough swatch. I overlined too much on this side. But it's very, very pretty. I do really like this color. I really don't see a dud so far, but there's the metallic next, which is never a good idea in my opinion, but let's go for it. Next shade is Kylie Claws. Ignore that there's foundation coming off around my neck, my mouth. Let's just get through this. This is Kylie Claws. Yeah, I can already tell I don't like this. Maybe this wouldn't be so bad over another lipstick, but on its own. So that's Kylie Claws. I look so crazy right now. But yeah, that's Kylie Claws. I think this wouldn't look so bad layered over one of the darker colors or the reds. I don't think it would be horrible. Okay, the last one in the set, which is Keep the Receipt. This is a very, very pretty red. This is definitely very, very orangey, which is good if you like orangey. I'm really kind of a blue-toned red person, but I have to admit, this is a very, very pretty red. And I love red lipstick. So, of course, I think this is a win in my book. It's definitely very, very vibrant. Very, very red-orange. Like a whoo! So with usually every holiday collection, Kylie comes out with a matte lip kit. Last year it was Kissmas, which was an orangey kind of color, which I actually really, really liked. This year it is Naughty List. The packaging is so, so cute. Very Kylie, very on theme with this whole collection. I love it. Of course there is a lip liner and lipstick. This red seems a bit different than her other reds, but I don't know. Sometimes I look at so many red lipsticks and I'm like, I don't know what's happening anymore. Okay, let's try this on and probably keep this on because my lips are crying. We have the liner, which is in the all red packaging, which is very cute. This almost looks a bit pinky. A bit pinky. Okay, let's just apply the lip liner. I'm too lazy to fill it in all the way. But this is Naughty List. The lip liner is definitely pinkier than the actual lipstick. This is so pretty. Oh my god. This is all of my red lipstick fantasies. I mean, you probably don't need this if you have a lot of red lipsticks like me, especially a lot of red liquid lipsticks, but it's so pretty. I love it. The last thing I got were the high glosses, which is one of my favorite things Kylie does in her collection. What's really cute about this packaging is the Santa Claus hat on top of the lipstick, and then some of these are shiny, and then some of them have glitter on them, which is so, so cute. And then on the inside, there is more Santa hats. There are three high glosses in here. This retailed for $36, the same as the miniature set. And there are three gorgeous colors in here, which are very holiday-y. I just love how much these all seem to match the collection. It's very cohesive, which was a complaint about her holiday collection last year, is that they weren't cohesive. What color should I put on? I'm not gonna swatch these on my lips because I already have lipstick on, but I think I should go for the... maybe the gold one? This is in the shade Must Be Magic. I love, love, love her high glosses. These have the cute little red chrome top. I love her high glosses because they have that chunky wand. I love a lip gloss with a chunky wand. Oh, look how pretty. This one is very gold. I love her high glosses so much. I've always, always, always loved Kylie's glosses, but her high glosses are so, so good. They're like kind of tied with Fenty Gloss Bombs. It's my all-time favorite lip gloss formula. There's something about the Fussy Gloss Bomb that I just love so much that's like my all-time favorite gloss, but the Kylie ones are so pretty. And this lip gloss is so gorgeous. I love it. I definitely think the high gloss set is killer. Be a great Christmas present because it's not necessarily so holiday themed that you can't use it throughout the rest of the year. But this gold over the red lip is so perfect for a Christmas party. I mean, look at that. Again, my mouth is suffering from being scrubbed with the makeup wipe so many times. But is that not just so gorgeous? Okay, so let's talk final thoughts. Obviously, I did not get this whole collection. I did not get the illuminating setting spray or the brush set or the illuminating primer. I thought all of those looked really, really gorgeous, but I just could not swing it with this year's budget, so I didn't. I picked up what I thought were the most exciting products. I'm really glad I got the glosses. I definitely didn't need the miniatures necessarily, but they were very, very pretty, and I like them. I think they're really cute. So, out of what I got, I really like the palette. I think it's very fun. Obviously, this isn't necessarily something you're gonna be pulling out all year round, which is, it's a fair point. Like, why do you need it if you're just gonna use it for December? But Christmas is my all-time favorite time of year. So I love having like this cute little December palette, and it's gorgeous. I really like the colors in here, and I feel like this formula, at least for her limited edition collections, is improved. It's better. I had a heck of a time last year blending those shadows, and then this year I feel like it's definitely improved. The minis were very, very cute. I definitely didn't need them, but they're very, 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 very cute. I liked them a lot. I especially liked Snowman Season. I thought that was so, it's a very, very pretty nude. I think her high glosses individually are like $16, so you're saving a little bit of money with these full-size beautiful ones. I think that they're so, so, so pretty. Would look perfect over any lipstick. Even this one, maybe on its own. I'm very excited to use all of these. I love, love, love high glosses. Overall, I thought this was such a fun collection. I love her holiday collections because it kind of marks like the beginning of Christmas for me. Obviously, that's a little bit deranged because most people think, oh, maybe it's Thanksgiving. But I'm like, no, it's when Kylie's holiday collection comes out. Mostly because I'm just absolutely obsessed with makeup. So, okay guys, I've babbled on so much about this collection. Tell me what you think if you ordered it, what you think down below. tell me what you'd like to see more of on this channel. I hope you had an amazing Thanksgiving. I love Christmas, so tell me what kind of videos you want to see. I'm very, very excited to continue on kind of like my festive videos. So let me know what you want to see, and I'll see you guys next time.